In Central Visayas, daily COVID cases have risen by 50% in the past week. It reported 570 new infections from July 10 to 16, raising the total of active infections to 923. So far, the number of severe and critical admissions is at 51, or nearly 9% of the total COVID-related hospitalizations. Health officials remind residents to continue following the basic health protocols.
With an update on the Philippines' COVID situation, the country reports more than 14,000 new infections in the past week. Health officials say the country averaged 2,091 new cases from July 11th to 17th. That figure was 44% higher from the week before. Some 589 patients are in severe to critical condition. The hospital bed utilization rate stood at 23.8%, while the ICU bed utilization rate was at 18.3%. Amid an uptick in COVID cases in parts of Visayas, Cebu City is aiming to further expand its vaccination campaign to include more minors. Mayor Michael Rama says he intends to open up vaccination sites in select schools and ramp up house-to-house inoculations. Data from the health department showed Cebu City has only vaccinated 0.66% of its eligible population for the pediatric group.
The formula there, Nikki and Mike, if you emphasize love, love cannot just bring parents the vulnerability of the children. If you are a parent, we know very well that there is always such a thing as regular vaccination, maybe whatever price that may be getting attractive, especially to the children, attractive to the parents, and attractive to the teachers. We must incentivize. We don't intend to compel, because compelling is unconstitutional.
The rise in new COVID-19 cases in the Philippines may continue until next week. That's according to the UP Pandemic Response Team fellow, Professor Jomar Robahante. He notes the positivity rate in the country continues to rise even as hospitalization rates remain low.
Yung gantong pag-increase, bababa, tapos i-increase, bababa, posibleng magtuloy-tuloy itong mga small ripples na ito until the last quarter of 2022. Parang meron tayong makikitang mga small waves like this sa mga susunod na mga buwan. The main reason is, syempre, mobile na yung population natin, open na yung borders natin, and also, nagwi-win yung immunity natin. Kasi we know na medyo matagal na yung mga, yung iba, hindi pa nagpapa-booster shot.
President Marcos urged to implement an anti-drug campaign within the rule of law and with high level of accountability. Global civil society group, Philippine Coalition for the International Criminal Court, made that appeal to mark the International Day of Justice on July 17th. The group is proposing several recommendations to the Philippine government. These include reviewing and rejecting the current bloody drug war and allowing the visit to the Philippines of UN Special Rapporteurs to assist government in upholding human rights. The Marcos administration is also urged to declare its cooperation should an ICC drug war probe resume, order the immediate investigation of cases, and review its position on the ICC towards the ratification of the Rome Statute and return to the court. The group hopes the Philippine government will act on the recommendations within the first 100 days of the Marcos presidency.
A pretrial chamber of the International Criminal Court asks the Philippine government to comment on the ICC prosecutor's request to resume its probe into the anti-narcotics campaign. Drug war victims and their families are also urged to provide observations by September 8th on ICC prosecutor Karim Khan's appeal. He found the Philippine government has not demonstrated that it has investigated or is conducting a probe with respect to crimes within the jurisdiction of the International Tribunal. Khan is in turn given until September 22nd to respond to the Philippine government's comment. The ICC prosecutor is looking at whether crimes against humanity of murder were committed in the government's drug war. The Philippine Justice Department has conducted two drug war reviews since February 2020. But so far, only a matrix of 52 cases has been released, which the ICC prosecutor rejected as mere desk review.